If you guys have any questions, I'd be most happy to take them. Anyone need my phone number? What am I doing tomorrow night? When's the bar being thrown open? Anything? Shanu? Tu to puchle yaar. Acha, theek hai, chalo, koi nahi. Sorry, yes sir. I'm sorry, I didn't hear that.
The director of the third one.
The director, incidentally, Bumpy is almost like Anish Bajpayee. He's coming back for his second film. Yeah, so Bumpy comes back to do the third one. Sorry? Three, at least. Of course. Also by Raghu Dixit. Background music for the second film?
I'm sorry, the songs.
Yes, of course they are.
Yeah, but you never played that.
Yeah, because the trailer didn't need that. But watch out for it. It's going to be a lot of fun. One of the songs is called Down Down. Those are the words. I'm not kidding. I wrote that. Sorry. What else? Yes, sir.
You got your adjectives right, heavily loaded.
The I didn't hear that, sorry.
Right. Okay, I'm saying you got your adjective right, whatever you're describing.
Okay.
The figures loaded, 60-70% youth population. The way it looks like, because you come from a background of MTV, which we all know, so the F word and the B word and the MC, whatever words are there in the promos, do you think with the censor it
will go... Yeah, sure, go ahead. We'll move it out.
Wait about the others, I'm not worried about myself or you. So, with the censors, where do you go with you or UA, and then it will cut out the same audience that you're targeting, isn't it?
Well, a UA would be something we'd be most happy with. So we're good with really it's not something that we're gunning for an A or a UA or a E. Finally, it's the film that decides or defines.
Because you're targeting the same audience between 15 to 30, I mean.
Yeah, but I think, finally the film needs to decide what certification it gets. I don't think we'll be saying, I'm not making a Disney movie, right? So if you want to catch any of that, there's also Sanskar TV on, so we can catch that. Sorry, someone else had a question here.
Mr. Patil, what will be your promotion strategy for these three films?
Okay.
What are your likely... theater outlets will okay. likely to
We've be. Got a pretty aggressive release strategy, and Sahdevji right at the back has completely made me sweat, because by no stretch of imagination is this a small release. We are going to be going out in close to 100 cities. We are in close to 400 screens, if I'm not wrong, if not more. That's as far as the release strategy goes. As far as the marketing piece goes, we're just getting started. If any of you are online, you'll already see some of the virals that we've already pulled out. There's a series of those. In fact, it's been constructed in such a way that it's the kind of content that people will want to not just view, but replay, like, and share. So there's an entire really twisted animated series, which is the Teddy series, inspired by Mad Magazine, One Fine Day at the Coffee Shop, blah, blah, like, just like that. So check that out. So there's a very aggressive digital strategy where a lot of our digital partners come into play and help us blow it out of the water. The conventional pieces, I think, you know, that's the challenge with a lot of the marketing which has happened in the past, that it's a template. And by design at Y Films, we want to burn those templates. Wo trailer, fir music video, fir interview, fir making of, fir walking onto a talent hunt, wo ho gaya, wo jalana hai abhi. So all the things that we're also going to be doing around the marketing of each of these movies is going to be pretty fresh and pretty new. So watch out for that, which is getting started.
Okay,
yes,
now...
You go ahead.
All right. Is it a conscious attempt that you're having newcomers for almost all the cast members as newcomers? In your forthcoming films, will the newcomers be highlighted? And the second question is that in UTV, we have a UTV Searchlight, where they have a low-budget films and a certain kind of films they cater to. Is it something of the similar sort from YRF?
Okay, I'll try and answer both of those. Yes, it's a conscious strategy to have completely newcomers. I think the... if we also land up making movies with Deepika and Ranbir, then there's no difference between what we're trying to do at Y Films and what Yash Raj Films does. The intent is to find the next Deepika and find the next Ranbir. Ditto, find the next Shimit Amin, find the next Kabir Khan. So yes, it's a conscious strategy. Having said that, these are kids who are all signed on with us for at least three films. So some of them will come back in future projects, one. Two, coming to your second question, I guess you meant UTV Spotboy.
Yes.
Right? So that's Fox Searchlight. So as far as Spotboy is concerned, I think Spotboy's slice is a budget slice. So they will also do a Devdi, they will also do a No One Kill Jessica. Though I don't know how that's a small budget film. But our slice is not a budget slice. Our slice is a very clearly focused audience slice. So no matter what we're making, be it a rom-com, be it an anti-rom-com, be it a caper, be it at some day I'm hoping I can make a zombie film, we will all be talking to the same audience consistently and consciously. Yeah?
But with newcomers, how will you be able to, with newcomers, how will you be able to create a traffic jam at the box office window?
Well, ma'am, I think we've had a mini success in the form of Band Baja Bharat, which had a fairly new team, in spite of the fact that Anushka may have been someone, you know, who's already done two films. But Ranveer, I think, has pretty much captured everyone's hearts and imaginations. Ditto Manish, who directed the film. So we've had a mini pilot and a pretty reasonable success with that film, I would say. So, and, you know, if we don't give this as a platform to new kids, then you're just going to keep seeing the Khans and the Kapoors. And I love them all. But you know what? Let's make some space for some new kids.
And even the content, I mean, don't you think it's more for the metro kind of audiences?
Yes and no. I think finally, you know, stories are always universal. You can never really box them into saying, ye sirf South Bombay mein chalengi, ye sirf Warsaw mein chalengi. I don't think so. I think finally there are stories. It's true. It's stories which cross over everywhere. Titanic, Jurassic Park, you know, but that's a different genre. Let's not go there.
Yeah, Ashish, Anil Banbari, do you have your stories in place for next year or are you looking for scripts for next year?
Are you pitching something, Anil?
Just checking.
Gotcha. Yes, we've already, I think, pretty much identified what at least two out of the next three projects are. But we are always looking for fresh new ideas, fresh new people. So if you've got some new tricks in the bag, bring it on.
All right, thank you.
Ashish, one more question. How do you differentiate?
Do you mind if I go to her for a second? You're kind of monopolizing my time, buddy. So just a second. Yeah. Sorry? Okay, for the next films, there's our website will go live. In fact, it's pretty much live now as we speak. Rock and roll, man. 5 o'clock dot. We are live with yfilms.in. Do check it out. It's a great fun website. Also live is lovekadien.com. So check out both of those places. You can throw in or send in your stuff, register over there. And there's also our wonderful casting director. She saves our lives and finds us all these rock stars. So that's one way to go about that. Yes. Yes, ma'am. I'll try and answer that. Okay, the only thing that we are tapping into as far as the mothership is concerned is A, production, and B, distribution, because there's just tremendous leverage sitting over there. Creatively, this is completely independent. It's an entirely new voice, and that's what, I mean, it's so wonderful working with someone like Adi and someone like Yashji. The first time we actually met the directors of the, our first director, Bumpy, was after he had signed on, after we had locked and loaded, pretty much like a week before the shoot. You know, and the only question I remember that Bumpy had was like, yaar, mujhe full pant pehne padenge kya? You know, so we have that kind of creative freedom and creative space, and that's what makes it so much fun. That's why we are able to find a new voice. And I mean this with no disrespect, that a lot of people who look at our promos tell us that, yaar, ye Yashraj se aa raha hai. Ye gana YRF studio ke andar se nikla hai. And which, frankly, I mean, it's wonderful. It's thanks to Adi and Yashji that who've given us that space and that belief and confidence to go out there and do what we need to do to connect with young people. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I want to know one thing. With the content being so unconventional and, you know, you are attempting cutting edge and path breaking stuff.
I'm glad you think so, man. That's a lot of adjectives. I hope everyone's recording that. Yeah, okay.
Anyway, that's your statement also. What I'm asking you is that your content for next year, is it all charted out, locked, or will it be modified on the basis of the response to these three films?
Well, we've got our top line thoughts already in place. But, you know, given the audience we're talking to, these are people who change their mind every second. And a year is a long way off. So if there's a hot new trend that comes along, something really interesting that happens, you can bet your ass that we're going to reflect that in our content.
You are clearly saying that, you know, your audience is one particular audience, and you are moving around the concept of young and new generation and whatever is going ahead with the new generation. But for how long do you think you can move around the same concept and still captivate the audiences?
Well, everyone's been doing that for the rest of the world for, I don't know how many years, 100 years? So, I mean, youth rules today, man. It's 70% of the country, really. So, I mean, forever, really. As long as you have a good story to tell and you can tell it well, we are the men with the plan. Yes.
Are you planning to take this international as well?
Yes, in a small way initially. And Avtar will back me up on that. We have a reasonably small size release, actually a big one in the Middle East. But the rest of the world, we're kind of testing waters right now. So we'll have a fairly interesting and aggressive digital strategy to be it looking at VOD, pay-per-view, all of that. So there's some interesting ideas on that. But You'll hear more about that in the coming weeks.
Hi.
We are not flexible at all. Do you want me to send you, mail you the P&L? Why don't you give me your email address? Next.
Hi, I have a question. You know, of late, everybody in the industry has been talking that the formula, the Bollywood formula is going. You know, it's always about a fresh story. Doesn't matter. The genre doesn't matter. Nothing matters. It's the honesty of the script and the execution that matters. And here you're saying that you're looking at targeting youth. I mean, that itself is looking at a trend and then weaving around a story. So,
it's always talking to a certain audience. Finally, if you're making a film just for yourself, it's a different matter. It's always about having a focus on audiences. And, you know, that's the other interesting thing. In fact, I'm glad you asked me that. You know, a lot of films are often made saying, yaar ye acha idea hai, chal banate. For the first time, what we're really trying to do is to tap into a lot of consumer insights and understand these young people. So, for example, let me give you a very specific example. I don't think you need rocket science or research to tell you that romance is big. 7 out of the top 10 hits of all time are romantic films, right? But what's interesting about romance today is that romance has obsessive intensity. Casual dating has made an entry. Frequent breakups are more and more often. And the meeting and mating grounds have moved online. That's a starting point for us. We will use this as a springboard, not as a shackle. That's the reason mujhse friendship karoge happens. So that's our starting point. So it's not really a formula. It's about using that. If you use research as a shackle, you'll be boxed in and you'll be stuck. But if you use that as a starting point to create new stories and ideas, I don't think you'll be stuck ever.
Thanks.
Hi. All right. Excuse me. Hi.
Priyanka, how are we doing on time? Okay. So, Can I ask just last quick question here?
All right. Hi. You had mentioned you were going to release this film across 100 cities, right? You were planning to reach out.
Yes.
Question I have is that while most of the movies orient such segmented, youth-oriented subjects, the top 6 metros, how are you going to reach out to the tier 2 towns? You know, how are you going to make sure that the tier 2 towns, which is, you know, the much more interior side of the segmented youth, which have more time to spend in cinema theaters, how will you reach out to them differently, apart from the digital strategy?
Well, I guess it's always a phased process. I wish I had the monies of Ambani, and I would say, baat do, charo taraf phela do. So, but it's going to be something that we do in a phased manner. Having said that, 100 cities, by no stretch of imagination, is small. Digital is just one of the pieces. We will, of course, supplement all of these in terms of a television strategy, a print strategy, a very aggressive PR strategy. And I think given the audience we're talking to, these are kids, pardon my French, who smell bullshit and who smell an advertising message a mile away.
So have you so done you any consumer insights in these cities or have you?
Absolutely.
In tier 2 towns.
Absolutely.
As well,
see, just to give you a quick background, I spent my last 12 years heading MTV. So I spent a lot of time trying to understand these young people. So yes, and incidentally, over the last 1 year, we've also tapped into a bunch of business schools across 2 to 3 cities who've done this consumer insight process for us, who help us understand this audience right, not just what kind of stories appeal to them, but how are they spending their money, how are they spending their time, what are their triggers. And that's where you're seeing some of those things reflect in the kind of themes and storylines we've picked. They are not your usual, like Sabha mentioned, Sarson ke Khet. You know, I don't think storylines like this have ever been mirrored before in cinema. They're waiting to happen. That's the reason there's a rom-com against the backdrop of social networking. That's the reason there's a story of a twisted hacker. Or for that matter, anti-rom-com. It's not yesteryear's Abla Nari who will roll over and play dead. She will not be sad. She will not get mad. She will get even. Love ka the end. I'll tell you what, we're going to continue right after this. The team of the first film of Love Ka the End, Bumpy, Shraddha, Taha, will be available for one-on-ones right here. So the news teams, media teams can come on over right now. As for the rest of you, the bar is now open. And also some spray cans. So do please spray on your wishes and your messages on our graffiti wall right outside. We'll see you guys in a bit. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Print one-on-ones is tomorrow at 2 o'clock.
Yes, and we're doing print one-on-ones tomorrow at 1 o'clock. So at 2 o'clock, I'm sorry. Thank you so much.